Leaked documents show that Uber's going public, eventually. Samsung wants iPhone owners to try Galaxy phones for just a dollar. Twitter's stock sinks below its IPO price, and more. It's Friday, August 21st, and this is Crunch Report. Okay, is it finally time for Uber to go public? According to a leaked document published by Reuters, yes! Or at least to the next 18 to 24 months. Which is not exactly around the corner. Think of all the unicorns that will die before then. What Reuters did get access to was a presentation that Uber is showing to potential investors in China as part of a new funding round for its international business, which included its future IPO plans. The presentation also showed some recent financial information for the company. Bookings were worth $2.91 billion in 2014, up from $687.8 million in 2013. This year, Uber expects revenue to hit $10.84 billion, and with the 20% commission model that it uses, about $2 billion for the company itself. Next year, it projects $5 billion in the same, essentially, take-home money. Now, of course, profit is a different story, subject to Uber's own spending, of course. Facebook, you held out valiantly. The network had never given in to animated, flashy banner ads that caught your eye and annoyed you, claiming they weren't interested in messing up the user experience. That is, until today. Now that users have gradually gotten used to video ads and video in general on Facebook, the company tells TechCrunch it'll start allowing businesses to post GIFs as ads and page posts as well. Wendy's, Coca-Cola's Brazilian brand Kuat are the first businesses showing off salad making and a Nyan Cat knockoff. You see what it does, though, it catches your eye. Facebook is phasing out the current sidebar ads, so GIFs won't show up there, only on boosted page posts. You might recall that Facebook started supporting GIFs in user posts back in May, although they never really caught on, at least not with my network. I've seen one that I can remember, and it's a GIF that I actually posted. But something tells me that brands will like the new, visually more aggressive option. They are brands, after all. Samsung wants you, iPhone owners, if you're living in the US, to try out one of their new Galaxy phones for just $1. That's for 30 days. But it is under a no-obligation plan. The trial includes a free data plan, and to get the most from a Galaxy device, which is not restricted to any single operator. If this seems a little desperate, let's look at how the companies stack up. Apple's most recent quarter, Q3, net profit rose 40% year-over-year to $10.7 billion. Samsung's mobile phone units operating profit fell 37.6% year-over-year to 2.76 trillion won. That's just under $2 billion. And its operating profit margin in the last quarter was 10.6%, a big drop from 15.5% in Q2 of 2014. You might recall, last week the company unveiled the Galaxy Note 5 and Galaxy S6 Edge Plus, and seems like the thinking is an attractively priced gimmick may give US users all that more incentive to drop the iPhone and pick up a Samsung instead. Okay, it's record lows all the way down in tech stocks as we wind down the week. Let's start with Twitter, which fell to its IPO price, that's $26 per share, at the market close yesterday for the first time since going public. Twitter's all-time high was $73.71 per share, which is nearly three times its current value. Shares have fallen more than 25% in recent months. We can't just single out Twitter, though. In general, tech stocks are just not happy. Alibaba also set a record low yesterday. Netflix dropped 7.8%. Facebook dropped 5%. And LinkedIn dropped 4.3%. At the market close today, Apple stock was down by more than 5%, bringing share prices down to $106.05. But hey, gold is up! Okay, I feel bad about Twitter, so let's talk about something a little bit more positive. That has to do with Twitter. You might remember back in May, Google and Twitter partnered to add tweets to Google's mobile search results. Today, Google announced, not with a lot of fanfare, but it was announced in a blog post, that they'll also be including tweets within search results on desktop too. Which means, if you're searching for something like Kate ate wine, the first result is a tweet from Twitter user Kate Eight talking about a scratch and sniff wine book. Sounds good. As TechCrunch's Drew Olenoff points out, it's a perfect match. Google helps you search for things. Twitter helps you find out what people are saying about things. Maybe Google should buy Twitter. Stock price didn't bounce back today. Just saying. That's our report for this week. I'm Sarah Lane. Crunch Report airs Monday through Friday at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, right here on TechCrunch.com. We will see you Monday.